If you hit the bad beat jackpot, would you tip the dealer? And if so, how much would you tip that dealer who literally had nothing to do with the outcome of your hand? What's up, guys? It's your man Brock here with another riveting journalistic expository piece, which falls under my playlist category of miscellaneous sports poop. But anyway, the reason why I'm asking about this bad beat jackpot scenario is because I've had numerous discussions about this with my brother, probably since we started gambling together. Now, my brother, he's kind of one of these, I don't know, semi-professional players. Dude's an absolute stud when it comes to the felt. I think he actually cashed like 75% of the tourneys he played in a couple years ago for that particular year. I think it might have been 2015, but I've lost thousands to him playing heads up just for fun. But I always ask him because I love hearing his answer because it's so brazen, but I really think it's in perfect line with the sentiment of the more than recreational gambler. And when I say that, I'm referring to people like me and him who essentially, we live to gamble. We love it. It's a huge part of our lives. But I always find myself asking him, dude, if you hit the BBJ, would you tip your dealer? And without any hesitation, he'll immediately snap back with an answer of no, followed by many expletives. By the way, here's my Christmas tree, which I did not decorate yet. Yeah, but anyway, you know what's funny? Gambling, more specifically poker, it's really like that drop-dead gorgeous girl, 10 out of 10 girlfriend who you're just enamored with, but she continues to cheat on you and break your heart. Some days I love the casino. I think it's the best thing ever created, and every town should have one. Not only am I friendly with my fellow players, but I become rather chummy and generous with the dealers and pit bosses as well. If you can't tell already, I like to talk, so it's easy to make friends that way. But boy, I'll tell you, there are some days when I am just a miserable bastard. I'm very forward with my fellow players, and I'm, well, very direct with any and all employees of that particular gaming establishment. If you're a real degenerate, I think we've all been there. True degens, of course. And you haven't truly gambled if you don't have a love-hate relationship with your pit boss or casino host. But let me get back on track here because this is a very interesting debate. And once again, the question is this. Would you tip the dealer if you hit the bad beat jackpot in the poker room? Now, for some folks, that's not even a legit question. It's a no-brainer. That dealer is going to get tipped, and they are going to get tipped generously. For me personally, I really never understood how overvalued dealers are to a lot of players, especially in the poker room. They treat their poker dealers like their best friends. I mean, I've worked in retail personally years ago, and I'll be honest with you, I wasn't always fond of the general public, and especially folks that thought I was their buddy. So I can't imagine how a dealer feels about their players, unto which they see every single day. And you know, it's a long session too. I mean, real cash game players are putting in minimum 8 hours a session. So that dealer's got to look at the same drooling faces in their rotation and then have to talk to them during their chip run as if the customer isn't holding them up. So I can really empathize with the dealer side of the house as well. I mean, seriously, it is the entertainment business. So providing a fun environment to your players is a part of the gig. And you're providing a game that's quick, organized, and you're providing a social aspect as well. So the role of the dealer is very important to the flow and overall enjoyment of the game itself. Now, as a player, more specifically a cash game player, I'm still just not sure about tipping the dealer when it comes to hitting the bad beat. I know that sounds ridiculous. I mean, that dealer did not have my back the night I went to the ATM 3 times and overdrafted the bank account. He didn't have my back. He didn't stop me. He just let me keep paying rake and tipping on chopped pots. And he let me keep getting pounded by a guy who obviously was better than me too. So if that particular dealer dishes out that bad beat, what in the blue hell did he or she have anything to do with those cards coming out the way they did anyway? Hell, if you're going to tip anybody, tip the card shuffler company who made the shuffle, which shuffled the deck under which you received your bad beat. If you're going to tip anybody, why not tip them? My other question is this, and listen, this is just all up for debate right now, but my other question is this. Depending upon the size of that bad beat, would that jackpot actually get you out of the red and into the black? Seriously, would a bad beat jackpot of, I don't know, $100,000, would that payout get you out of the red and into the black? Let's be honest with ourselves. For a lot of people, that answer is no, and not even close. So is it right for you to tip somebody for their services when you're still at a loss? If you slip and fall at a Walmart, do you give them a token of appreciation and write them a check thanking them for your agony? But for argument's sake, let's say that tipping the dealer who dealt you the bad beat is the noble and right thing to do, which, like I said, is very expected out of both the casino and the dealers and fellow players. Well, the dealers are providing you a tip service, and they're yielding you results very favorable and enjoyable to you. How much is the right amount? How much is too much? 5%? 10%? 20% of your jackpot that you've waited countless hours and paid thousands of dollars worth of rake for? Think of how much money you've paid in that jackpot over the course of your lifetime, and how many hours you've spent in the poker parlors. You paid into it. You paid for the jackpot. Do you want to continue paying into Social Security when you're in your 60s? You've paid into it your whole life. Isn't it time to now get it and retain it? Why would you continue to put more in if you don't have to? Now, I've asked a ton of friends who obviously are players, and believe it or not, I get mixed responses. And to be honest with you, some say without question, absolutely, I'd absolutely tip the dealer. And some of those guys would actually give up a lot more than others. And personally, I ain't got no problem with it. God bless you, and God bless that dealer. But in knowing some of these dealers personally, and being friends with them, I just don't know if anything you give them would be enough. If you hit for 100K, overtipped and gave them 10K, they'd be mad because it's only 10%. And if you hit for 200K, gave the dealer 20,000, they'd be upset because you didn't give them more. At least that's the notion I get from my dealer buddies. And if you're a dealer out there and you're watching this video and I'm wrong, please correct me in the comments section below. At the same token, though, I can really put myself in the dealer's shoes, too. Dude, I just dealt you $250,000 jackpot. It's $250,000 you didn't have before. Listen, dude, I got a family. 30K will go a long way, and you're not even going to miss that money. Put it to a good cause. You're just going to give it right back to my bosses anyway. And that's a very valid point, and it's a very valid argument. And me personally, I tend to agree with that sentiment as well. So here's where my debate's going. I can argue either way. And at this point in my expository piece, I hope that you're starting to see and realize that this whole thing isn't as easy as saying yes or no. And once again, my question is this. If you hit the bad beat jackpot, would you tip the dealer? And if so, how much? Guys like my brother, who's kind of a scorned, war-torn, 72-hour bender-style player, if he makes the decision that he's not going to tip, how can I tell him otherwise? I've seen the way he plays over the years. He's certainly done his part. But then you got a guy who really appreciates the casino and the poker parlor. And really, who wouldn't? They provide a safe game, an organized game, and they offer incentives for you to keep playing the game. Free drinks, high hand every hour, random hot seat, generous comps, organized tournaments, and obviously, the bad beat jackpot. So ultimately, folks, my soliloquy is going to come to an end, but this is a question that may or may not have a right answer. But it's certainly something that I've discussed for many years since Poker Room started offering the bad beat. So if you're a social player, or if you want to get your opponents to open up and start talking, this question is a great way to get tells and see what type of player they are just through their personality and the way they hold a conversation. Hell, even the way they answer the question. But regardless, if you're looking to get, you know, the game a little bit looser from the social aspect, bring up that question. Would you tip the dealer? And if so, how much? By the other player's response, you'll get a great idea of what kind of player they are and how long they've been playing the game. And that can be imperative to finding out where exactly you're at skill-wise in that particular game at that table. All right, folks, thanks for tuning in. Once again, I do sports picks and all kinds of different random stuff. So if for some reason you tune into any of my sports picks, just keep in mind I'm not a sports betting expert, nor do I implore you to take any of my picks. A wise man once said, good ain't free, and free ain't good. If for some reason you decide to use the free information on my program, you're utilizing it at your own discretion. Most importantly, if you're betting any of these games, or gambling for that matter, do it safe, do it responsibly, and most important, have fun. For Brock Page Productions, I'm Brock Page, and have yourself a positive day.